Hi there. In our last video, we have seen how we can download and install the Python setup on your computer, and I hope the computer is ready with the Python installation. Now let's directly get started with programming. So this is the Python idle shell that you open when you open the Python. You can directly get started with writing down your program over here also. So to compare with or to begin with, any programming language's first program is always a Hello World program. So what you do in Hello World program is you just print some text onto the screen. Now I have told you that even if you are a student or a professional or a school going person or a college going or a university student, you can all refer to this course to learn Python even without any programming knowledge or even without any previous programming expertise. Still, I'm going to show you a very small example of how a Python code gets compared with a C code. In C programming, the very first thing we need to do to write down our Hello World program is this. And we write down our Hello World program like this, printf, and then we close the curly bracket. So that's a Hello World program for C language. In Python, your Hello World program is print, bracket open, Hello World, and that's it. There are no hash includes, there are no void mains, there are no opening closing curly brackets, hell, there is no semicolon as well. So Python syntax is very clean and very, very simple, straightforward. As you can see, I have used single double quotes while printing Hello World there. Instead of that, I can also use single quotes. The only condition is whichever quote you use while beginning the quotation, end it with the same quotation mark. Now, I can also directly write down a variable like this, because Python is an interpreter driven language where each line of the code is executed one by one. We'll see about interpreter and compiler as a difference in a separate video. So let's understand for now that it's interpreter driven, means every line is executed as we type them, or every line is executed individually. Because of that, what happens is we don't need to tell the computer explicitly that I'm going to make use of A as an integer or as a float or as a character. You can directly put a value into a variable by typing its name. So B is equal to 49, for example, and like that. For printing these variables, you can just write down print A or print B, whatever the name of the variable. So unlike C, there are no special syntaxes for printing the variables. Just open up a curly bracket and you can print into it. No, sorry, not a curly bracket, but just a bracket. If I want to perform addition, then it's as simple as that. C is equal to A plus B. And then I can print C. As simple as that. Now you can go on writing your code like this, but it's not that user friendly, because every time I write a line, that line gets executed. I want to write down the program at once, and then I would like to save it. So I'll just take a new file, and here I will write down my code, whatever it is. So that's two numbers I'm taking. And then C is equal to A plus B, and then print C. I can also write down like this if needed. Print addition is, and C. Now save this. Preferably I'll store it in a location, say documents, and here I'll create my codes, and this is my section 1. I'll just type it hello. So that's the code. This is how you can write down a program in a separate file. Once the file writing is done, or once you have completed writing down your code, you can run your program by going into run menu and by just clicking the run module, and that will run your program on the shell. This window over here is called as Python shell. By default, the font on your Python shell will not be this much. So just go to options, configure idle, and here you can change the font size depending upon your choice. So this is the addition. If needed, you can just change the values and see if the program is correct or not. As many times as you want, you can run the code. So that's about it, about how we can just print a text or any number onto the Python. In our next video, we'll see some operations like accepting inputs and then printing them onto the screen. Thanks for watching this video.